professional quality vinyl stickers at home? Is it possible? Absolutely. Are you ready to get started? Let's do it.
First thing you want to do is, it doesn't matter which graphic arts program you're using, but you want to lay out your stickers across your 8.5 by 11 page. And you want to make sure they fit within the print area, because sticker paper is pretty expensive, so you don't want to screw this up. The easiest way to do this, it doesn't matter whether it's CorelDRAW, which one I'm using, or you're using Photoshop or Adobe Illustrator or anything like that. Go down to Print Preview. All programs have this. In the professional world, this is called Prepress. And you want to make sure that your print is going to come out the way you want it. And the biggest thing I look for when I go into print, Prepress or Print Preview, is I want to make sure my stickers are all going to fit within the print area. And in most programs, it'll show you the print area with a dotted line around the actual page. This is pretty important, because you don't want to screw up half your stickers because they don't fit on the page. So looks like we're all set, so let's
project. I'm using inkjet printable vinyl from Papilio. And I made this video a couple years ago, and I still have not found anything better than this stuff, man. It's really good. And go check them out, man. Papilio makes all sorts of cool, fun stuff for your printer. But this stuff still works great. Inkjet white waterproof vinyl is the stuff you're looking for. If you want to make clear stickers, use the clear one. But remember, you can't print white, so whatever color you put your clear stickers on, they're just like my decal video. They got to be dark, and they need to go on a light background. But with white waterproof vinyl, you can print any color you want, but you're going to have a white background. All right, I've got your run-of-the-mill inkjet printer. I'm going to load my vinyl, make sure that the whichever way your printer loads. Most home printers load with the print side down, so because obviously it goes in and comes around and comes back out. So I'm going to load my white printable vinyl in, and we're all set. You're going to use your stickers inside, around the house, make a cool collage. You can do something cool inside. Then you're all set, man. Cut them out. You're good to go. But if you're going to use them outside, you've got to protect them, because right now, even though this is waterproof vinyl, they get rained on twice, even three times at the most. Eventually, they're going to start to fade. Also, sunlight is going to fade these things really quick without an overcoating. I'm going to show you a really simple trick to make them pretty good without having to buy something else. And then I'm going to talk about how to make them super durable if you want them to be super shiny and good for a long time. Option number one, you can just use crystal clear enamel, or even acrylic will work fine in this application. A light coat is all you really need. Option two to protect your stickers is to use an over laminate, and I'm going to use the Polyfocus from the same company, Papilio. Now, if you're going to use an over laminate, I recommend that you go ahead and make sure you grab your ruler. It's going to help you tremendously, and I'll show you why. The best way to do over laminate is to get it started. Start at the very, very top. Make sure everything lines up. And then stick it all the way across the top. The big thing with over laminate is you want to make sure whatever you do not want any air bubbles. And that's why I always use my trusty ruler when I do this, because the easiest way to do it is put your ruler down once you got the top good. Make sure you got no air bubbles across the top. Put your ruler down. Now I'm going to reach under and I'm going to grab the back of the paper right here. And I'm going to start pushing down with my ruler. I'm going to fold it back down and keep my hand on the bottom here, and then bring my ruler down. This is the best way to do over laminate and not get any bubbles whatsoever. So here's what the difference looks like. This is laminate. This is clear coat enamel. As you can see, the laminate will always beat out. It's a little bit more clear and a little bit, you know, offers definitely a little bit more protection, and you can get laminates that will actually protect against UV and sunlight. But I'm telling you, clear coat does a pretty good job, and it's 10 times cheaper. So it's up to you. When it comes to cutting out your stickers, you've got two options again. One, you can use good old scissors. Alright, the problem with scissors is you're not always going to get a super straight cut, and you'll really notice cuts that are off with that have on stickers that have a white background. So my favorite is to use a metal ruler and a razor blade. With these two tools, you'll get straight cuts every time if you just take your time and
take
your time in this step. I guarantee you it's always worth it. One of the easiest ways to line up straight cuts on paper is with a metal ruler, line up the corner with the corner or the flat edge with the flat edge. Another tool you can use is a T-edge or a square, but this usually works. I will give you a little bit of advice here, just because I've done this for a few years. Whenever you're cutting out stuff, especially with a metal ruler and a razor blade, you always want your design on the side that's obviously not under the ruler, because if you start to cut and your design is under your ruler, you'll always screw it up and you'll miss the actual spacing. So even if you need to take your design and flip it over to get a good cut, do it, because it's worth it to be able to see your design. This is why a lot of dudes actually, when they're drawing and laying stuff out, they use clear rulers. But when you're cutting with a razor blade and a metal ruler, you're going to have a hard time finding a clear metal ruler. So always keep your design on the outside, and that gives you a good idea where you want your spacing. Also, don't worry if you screw this up. I've screwed thousands of these up, and I've gotten pretty good at it over the years. The big thing is once I have it locked down, I'm really pushing hard on this ruler, because as you bring your razor blade and you kind of slide it against the ruler wants to move, and I do it all the time. And I curse myself. Here we go. Bam. So that was a good one. Now I can just trim this one up, keeping my design on the other side. One of the ways I definitely will transition over to scissors is as soon as I have my stickers a lot shorter, a lot smaller, then you can easily transition over to scissors and still get very, very straight cuts. Scissors just will never give you good straight cuts over a long distance though. Last but not least, you always have the option to cut your stickers out and actually get the shape. I will tell you, this can be very, very frustrating, because just remember, with a white background, everybody is going to notice even the slightest mistake. Now, this design, I'm actually pretty lucky because it's super simple and I can gauge the outline and try to give it a very, very similar outline on each side. But still, it's always going to be a challenge. Don't frustrate yourself. If you wonder how the pros do it, well, that's simple. They just use a computer and use a vinyl cutter and actually line up the vinyl cutter with the printed stickers, and the vinyl cutter cuts out the stickers. So that's how the pros do this. And I will tell you, that is actually not even easy at all either, because I've done that. I've got a vinyl cutter, and trying to get it to line up and cut out stickers just the way you want them is still frustrating. So if you're anything like me, you got a ton of stickers, and you can only put so many stickers on your car before people start thinking you're a total weirdo. So what are you doing with them all? I love collecting stickers. You know what? Most of them end up getting thrown in the trash after you move three or four times, because you're like, man, what in the world am I gonna do with these things? And they go away. But if you're anything like me, you love stickers. So I found a really cool way to hold on to your stickers, and I call them sticker boards. And it's really, really easy to make. All you have to do is get a piece of foam core board, and you can get foam core anywhere, especially at Walmart. And my favorite is black, because it gives a really good background for most stickers. And just collect your stickers on these little boards. And the trick is to start with a small board, fill it up, and then move to another board. And then pretty soon you'll fill these things up over and over. And these are really cool. You can put them on your wall or anything. So what am I gonna do with my new stickers that I just made? Of course, I'm gonna put them on my sticker board, and I got a perfect little space right there. also a great way to stick your stickers directly to your work table. All right, I got it. I got it. Nobody panic. I got it. I got it. I got it. Peel it up. Nobody will notice. Nobody will notice that you made a huge mistake. All right, cool. We're good. We're good. Everybody calm down. We're good.